Hi everyone, Anthony Fantano here, the internet's busiest music nerd, and it's time for another edition of Great Albums, where I go over a bunch of records from this past month and also the start of this year in this video that I thought were great, that I thought were worth mentioning again, that I did not want them to slip through the cracks on you. Please pay attention to them. I've reviewed them, for Christ's sake. So, yeah. All the albums I'm talking about are linked down below along with my reviews of those records. Let's go. First, want to shout out the new King Krule record, Man Alive. Archie is back with his first record in a while, and it's a lot more direct than The Ooze. Still pretty jazzy, dreary, post-punky, and experimental. Found a lot of the instrumentals on this one to be stark, the performances and the mood to be dejected and intense. Given how abstract and how sad all of it is, it's not going to be for everyone, but I recommend it. That much is clear. Next, HMLTD, West of Eden, crazy post-punk band out of the UK with an insane energy, lots of social commentary in their music as well. Very animated, very out there, very fun, quite possibly my favorite record of the year so far. I will say that. It's pretty early in the year, yeah, sure, but it's fantastic. It's a fantastic LP. Really a revival for the freakiest and most wild and energetic and slightly gothed outside of the genre, but revitalized, refurbished in a way where it makes sense for today. The new Against All Logic deserves some attention as well. 2017-19, Nicholas Jarr comes back with a new crop of tracks under the Against All Logic name. Doesn't quite sound like the first album in terms of aesthetics and textures and a lot of the influences going into it, but I like that things are slightly more experimental and a little more left field this time around, not just simply the groovy, moody, slightly micro, slightly outsider house that was on the first record, which can get kind of old if you're not diversifying. That's what this record does, and that's what it's all about, and it's a skilled LP. It's a skilled LP. I think anybody who has been thinking that Nicholas Jarr and Against All Logic isn't deserving of the attention that the project has gotten based off the first record needs to do a bit of a reassessment, because, you know, now he's effectively two for two. Denzel Curry and Kenny Beats come together for a series of wild and glitchy and colorful and cartoony bangers on Unlocked. Not much more to say about that. It's short, but it goes hard. The new Dan Deacon record, Mystic Familiar, is quite possibly my favorite Dan Deacon record thus far. It is trippy, it is colorful, it is kaleidoscopic. It's pretty Flaming Lips influenced at a few points, very beat heavy as well. Dan does some different stuff with his voice that he hasn't quite performed on other records, sounding a bit more raw and upfront. Of course, Neo Psych and post-minimalism come together on this LP, as it tends to do on most of Dan's work, and it's just a good crop of tracks, many of which flow into each other very tastefully, so it feels like a pretty cohesive experience all around. The new Poppy record, I Disagree, is a rager of lots of interesting, fun metal songs and some weird, almost, I'll say, Mr. Bungle-esque transitions here and there on a few tracks into other sounds and styles. It has a lot of charm, a lot of character, and a lot of grit as well, with it being a metal record. Also want to shout out another release from a UK artist in this video. We have quite a few of them in this episode, but Stormzy, Heavy Is The Head. I know this one dropped late 2019, so it took me a while to get to it because I had Classics Week and all that stuff, but this is a great record. Stormzy is very much deserving of all of the praise and respect that he gets as one of the best and most well-known rappers in the UK right now, because not only is he a quality lyricist and a spitter, but on top of it, he writes good songs. He writes from the heart, and he pens some really compelling lyrics on this record too. The final record that I want to mention in this video is Mac Miller's Circles. The rapper, producer, singer-songwriter's posthumous record here is an incredible one. Really strong songwriting, consistent aesthetic and sound, very personal and introspective angle on a lot of the tracks too. The biggest shame of this LP is that Mac was not around to hear just how good it ended up coming out. So rest in peace to Mac Miller, and I think that is going to be it as far as the albums that I want to redirect your attention to in this video. Thank you for watching. Transition, have you given any of these albums a listen? Did you love them? Did you hate them? What would you rate them? You're the best, you're the best. What should I review next? Hit the like if you like. Please subscribe and please don't cry. Hit the bell as well. Over here next to my head is another video that you can check out. Hit that up or the link to subscribe to the channel. Anthony Fantano, albums, great ones, forever.